I heard later a story, which I'm pretty sure is true. When he was at Cornell, Dyson had a office mate. I think his name was something like Huff or something. And this guy who was at Brookhaven told me this story. He said Dyson would come into the office about 11 in the morning. He'd read the New York Times. He'd go to lunch. He'd scribble for about a half an hour and then take a nap and then leave. And so this guy said, you know, he's a pleasant guy, but I mean, he's obviously, you know, not going to get anywhere what he's doing. And then keeping this up, after a few months, these set of papers on quantum electrodynamics came out. This guy said this guy left theoretical physics. There's no point.